Gravity Rush on the Vita feels at home. I initially played the game on a PS4, and I wasn't that impressed by the experience I had with the remastered version of this game. Playing the game with a controller felt emulated, because essentially it was emulated. But when I got to play the game on the Vita, even if it's the very same game, I couldn't leave my hands off the game for hours. I didn't play it till the end because I already did with the PS4 version, but when I got my hands on the Vita with this game, I played a solid 3 hours without leaving the screen. It felt much better playing it on the Vita. In the game you play as Cat, a girl who wakes up with no memory and who is followed by a cat that grants her the ability to shift gravity. And while she learns how to use her powers, the townspeople are being attacked by the Nevi. The gameplay is unique and is the key factor that made me excited to play the game. You shift gravity in order to explore the world. Her scarf always shows how the gravity is outside of her abilities, so that when her abilities expire, you know how to manage the situation. Aside of exploring, you will also use these mechanics in combat. You have some kick attacks. Nevi have red orbs on them, and that's their weak spot. You have to kick each enemy in those spots. There is no difference in strategy, the difference is just that each enemy has more or less spots and differently distributed spots on them. The combat gets repetitive and sometimes feels sloppy, but it still works and is very fitting to the setting and to the game mechanics. The story isn't for everyone. For example, I remember playing the game on a PS4 and being displeased by the lack of voice acting. There is no voice acting in the game, aside of some intangible noises. All of the dialogue is in text bubbles. And some of the story is in comic book panels, which is very cool. But the text bubbles aren't all that cool. It's okay for a Vita, though some voice acting, even lower quality clips like in other Vita titles, will have made things more interesting than text bubbles. But I can't hold it against the game. It's just a personal preference of mine. I have to admit that the text bubbles are still very fitting to the style of the game, the jazzy feel of the game. Even the music is jazz or tends towards it. And I like it. Overall, the game is innovative, and I had more fun playing it on the Vita than on a PS4, even if the two versions are the same game. The game has some downsides, like being repetitive, or maybe to some the storytelling is weak. So, while the game is definitely not for everyone, if you don't mind a game with only text bubbles, a weak story, but with an innovative, but somehow repetitive gameplay, try the game out. Okay, so this was the video. If you liked it, please hit the like button and subscribe. If you want to financially support me in my pursuit to review as many video games as possible, you can do that on Patreon or on the channel's membership section. You will help me a lot. If you want, you can follow me on Twitch, Instagram or Discord. And if you want to see another video of mine, just wait till I stop talking and there will be thumbnails of other videos I've made. Thanks for watching.